Now I'm going to discuss array of structures. In the previous lecture, we have discussed how to create a structure, how to input its data elements, and how to take outputs of all the data elements of a structure. And in that program, we have learned that for every single variable of a structure, we have to write a complete code. Fine. Suppose there are 50 students in your class, then you have to write same code for 50 students again and again. To overcome this issue, we'll use array of structure. In this, we don't need to create separate variable for that. Instead, we just need a single array which can hold the complete record of a student. See, this is structure template, struct student. These are its three elements, name, roll number, and marks. And there are three variables. Suppose if there are 50 students in your class, then I need to declare 50 variables of this type. Fine. And I have another solution, which is we'll mention over here stu and then number of students. And then semicolon. This is called array of structure. Now, by using this variable, data of 50 students can be entered. So we can store record of 50 students by using array of structure. Now we'll see this thing through program. This is our previous program. Now I will replace it with array of structures. See, in this program I have created the same structure. Now here three variables are created. Now instead of three variables, array of structure will be created. I will create it only for three students, because then we need to enter data for 50 students. If I mention here 50, the loop can go up to 50, but for teaching you, I will refer here three only. Now you know that when there is an array, then an array can be accessed using loop. So wherever there is an array, loop is used. So we'll perform the input and output using for loop. First, there will be a message, enter student info. Then we will use loop for I is equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus. We have to declare I also, int I. Here we'll give message, enter student name, gets. Since the variable name is stu, so we'll mention here stu dot name I. Because we are using array of structure, since this is an array, since there is three, so here I will mention stu I dot name to refer to the first element of the structure. Then scanf statement will be used, percent d for roll number and percent f for marks. Again, I will use stu I dot roll number. This is called IntelliSense. It is automatically detecting its elements. Now, stu I dot marks. Stu I dot marks, stu I dot roll number, and stu I dot marks. This is of type integer and marks is of type float. Then this is how input will be performed. The same code will be repeated for output. For that, we will use like this. This for loop is used again. Here we'll not mention enter student name. Here I need to print one another message, printf enter student roll number and marks, because we are doing this in single statement like this. If I'll give separate messages for roll number and marks, then I need to write scanf statement two times. One is for roll number and other is for marks. Now here we'll see the output. For that I'm giving here a message, printf student record students record. Here we'll not mention enter student name, we'll just mention student name. Then his name will be displayed. Here I'll mention printf instead of scanf. Here we'll write roll number. Slash n marks slash f So this is the code for displaying the result. First of all, we have created array of structure that is 2, 3. Then by using loop, we have entered these values. You just need to understand this code. For first student, I'll write stui.name, stui.rollNumber, and stui.marks. Instead of just stu.name, stu.rollNumber, and stu.marks, we'll mention here stui. When the loop will run, initially its value will be 0. Since it is true, 0 is less than 3 is true, it will go inside the loop. The message will be displayed, enter student name. Then through get s, student 0 dot name will be entered. That means it is asking the name of first student. Similarly, student 0 dot roll number, it is asking for, here I'll need to write ampersand because these are input statements. Stui dot roll number means stu 0 dot roll number. That means it is asking the roll number of first student. Stu 0 dot marks, asking the marks of first student. Then loop will be repeated where I will be 1. Then stu 1 dot names, stu 1 dot roll numbers, stu 1 dot marks. Then again, stu 2 dot names, 2 dot roll number, and 2 dot marks. And then loop will be terminated since it will become false. Now the same code is repeated for output, but here printf statement is used instead of scanf. Now we'll save and execute this program to see what are the results. There is some error. Let me see. I didn't use semicolon over here. This is the error. What happened? Here I didn't use semicolon. This is the error. Forgot semicolons. Now it is executing. I'm sharing the output window. See, enter student info. Enter student name. I will give the name over here. Suppose student name is Kajal. Enter student roll number and marks. Suppose I will give roll number 101 and marks 85. See, it is asking the name and roll number of second student, Renu. Wait, there is some error. For your convenience, I have separated all these statements for taking input. The first statement will displaying messages to enter student name, then scanf using %f, then to enter student's roll number, and then to enter student's marks. Now we'll execute it and we'll see the output. See, it is asking for student's name. I will enter here the name. Let's suppose it's Kajal. Roll number 101 and marks. Then another student's name. Roll number, marks. Then third student's name. Roll number, marks. See, it is showing the record of every student. Student's record, name Kajal, roll number 101 and marks. Name Richa, roll number, marks. Name Hina, roll number and marks. So it is showing the complete record of all the three students. Therefore, by using array of structures, we can enter data of as many as students as you want. I have run this program for three students. You can execute it for any number of records, any number of students. Since we have created this structure for student, you can also create it for anything like book, inventory, department or anything. One more thing I want to tell you that since I have declared structure variable over here, stu3, we can also declare it over here, stu3, and we'll remove it from here. No need to write over here. Then the procedure will be same. Here this is called global variable and here it is called local variable. So this is how we use structures and nesting of structures. Now I will give assignment.